to the Radnor Township Design Review Board meeting. Please, if you haven't already done so, we'd ask you to turn off your cell phones. Keep in mind, these meetings are televised live, so when you approach the podium, please tell us who you are, the business you represent, and you can lay out your plans on the desk next to the podium. So before we get into the agenda, I'm going to ask Cindy Ritz if she'll lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Okay, first on our agenda tonight is DRB 2016-22, the application of music and arts at 371A West Lancaster Avenue in Wayne, zoned under planned business for a ground sign and a wall sign. Hi, Greg.
Hello. Good evening, everyone.
Hi.
I'm Greg Feld from KC Sign Company, representing Music and Arts, and actually Snap Kitchen after this one.
So, saw that.
Figured take care of two at once. Music and Arts is moved in there. They're proposing a set of channel letters, normal channel letters, white acrylic faces. The cans in the background will match the facade there. It's like a chrome color on those. And then the size of that is 24 square feet on the storefront. The letter height is 2 feet, which is generally a little more than is what is smiled upon. But we were hoping to get a little taller letters there because the Music and Arts logo is so scrunched, it's very condensed. So if we made it small, like a foot or a foot and a half, that would get really tiny in that area. So because it doesn't extend out horizontally very much, we were hoping for a little more vertical height on that just to give it a little more presence in the shopping center. And the 24 square feet is well under what's allowed,
right,
square footage wise. So we think that's pretty good looking there on the facade there. It's scaled pretty well.
Comments?
Oh, yes, you probably heard my comment. Really, I just said the letters are taller than what we've allowed the other applicants in that shopping center. And I understand what you're saying about the logo. I can see that. I'd like to see the letter size brought down a little anyway, because we, instead of going by how the logo fits the space, which might be one criteria we should consider, but what I just think it's fair to, everybody comes in with the tallest letter they can, and then we try to make them consistent, or at least fair. I was thinking, we just talked about it. Were we, what did Coom?
Well, they had two.
One
stacked on top of the other. So they were, if you add it all up, probably about 24 total.
Yeah.
For the upper and bottom.
I mean, I would think 16, somewhere between 16 and 18.
Greg, you have a banner. I'm sorry. You have a banner up there now, I think,
right?
There's
a temporary banner.
Is that the appropriate size you would use or not, do you know?
I haven't driven by there to look at it. I brought in the paperwork for it, but I think it was the same size as this, I believe. I'm not positive, though.
I wonder if I can find out.
Okay. Lisa, what do you think on that?
I think they could go a little larger just because...
Or a little smaller?
Yeah. I mean, smaller than what it is, but... Because of the double height of the other one, but they could go a little larger than just the single letter.
Gotcha.
Okay. I was wondering what we did, for instance, FedEx on their big letter.
Yeah, who knows? I don't know if you have that in your book there.
It'll turn up eventually.
Within the scale of the other side.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. I know the background's in pretty good shape, so that's one thing we don't have to worry about. Yeah, check that out. And David, what do you think there? It's more of a, I mean, it fits the square footage requirements.
I do.
And it's more aesthetics.
I think from an aesthetic standpoint, I agree with what you said. It's like if you lower it, just basically conform with the rest of the lettering of the other shops.
So like the maximum height on one of the other storefronts there, kind of match what that is.
Yeah.
What did you put on your Rita's Winter Ice, do you remember? That thing's awful big, you know?
I know because
it was only Rita's.
We brought that down a little bit on
It's still pretty big, yeah. Of course, it was only four letters.
Oh, that's
so
in the...
facing the farmer's
facing
market.
Facing the other, yeah.
Yeah.
And that's one of the reasons that we let it be larger, because it doesn't face the road.
Right. Yeah. Okay, well, Cindy's going to just look up and see if she can get some...
Is Premier Cleaners in that shopping center?
I think they've been in and out. I'm not sure if they're
still
there.
Okay, we gave them 14
okay
letters. I know I have...
Looking at the one,
I mean, I think Greg's got a good point, the way that, so it's kind of squished together, that music and arts that, okay.
It's a weird logo for them to have to work with, and for sign companies.
I know it is, yeah.
Have to work with, too.
Yeah. So, Greg, you're going to do a raceway on that?
Yes.
Okay. And that'll be white, or?
The raceway will match the facade.
Match, that's right. What am I saying? Yeah.
And the letters will be?
White.
White.
Okay.
Yeah, they'll eliminate white.
And height from grade, everybody's pretty much the same on there. So you're going to be within the 15 feet?
Yeah.
Okay, Cindy?
How about 18 inches? We gave FedEx, we approved their uppercase letters not to exceed 18 inches. I know they have, the rest of their logo is smaller, it's a little bolder than yours, but if you had 18 inches all the way across instead of the 20, would that be, what do you all think of that?
Well, they're asking about 24.
Oh, you're asking for 24? Oh, then I think we got to go down a little bit, 20.
20?
20. 20 would be my maximum.
Yeah, I think 20 would.
Okay.
It's still kind of small, I think, just the way it is, but that's.
Well, I don't want it to look funny on the facade, too. So if you took it down, that's 24. If you went down 20, it's like 20%. Yeah. Is it? Am I right?
You know, no, not quite. Next door,
well, I can see that right there, line that L up, and you can see it's smaller but bolder.
Right. Mm-hmm.
They have a long.
Okay.
Oh, that's Sterling.
Sterling Optical is next to them, so they have that longer name kind of stretched out there.
You're right with 20, Greg?
We could do 20.
Yeah. Okay. Right. You're right, David?
Yeah, I'm good.
20, okay. All right. And you're asking for a ground panel, too, I believe, for the monument sign?
And the tenant panels, their name on the tenant panel,
okay.
Same to match everybody else's there.
Okay, fine. Opaque background and all that.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Okay. It's been a new business. Just make sure, again, that address is on the building. I know we've mentioned that before.
Somewhere on the, okay.
Yeah. And I don't know if they plan on doing anything in the window for graphics, but
they haven't mentioned anything to us about
okay.
that.
Okay, no. On plan business, you're only allowed 15% of your
I'll
window space.
No.
Yeah.
Okay.
Can we get them to? Excuse me. Can we get them to label that back door also?
Yeah.
With their, I think 4-inch letters on the back door, or so with a number.
Okay.
So we could do an address on the front and then put the 4-inch on the back door too.
Yep. Yeah.
Okay. Good. Okay, good. All right, anything else, comments, questions? You're all right? You guys all right?
Mm-hmm.
Lisa, you all right? Okay, you want to take this one?
Sure.
Okay.
In the matter of DRB 2016-22, Music and Arts proposal for a new sign.
Approve 20 inch.
I approve. Now I have a second?
20 inch.
I'm sorry, subject to the 20 inch lettering.
Okay, and
address on the back address.
Yeah, and the address, back address on the door.
Okay. All right, do I hear a second?
Second.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay.
Aye. Greg, you're all right then? 20 inch, you know?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Thanks.
Thanks.
All right, next is DRB 2016-23, the application of Snap Kitchen at 775 East Lancaster Avenue in Villanova for two wall signs and a freestanding sign. All right, Greg.
Okay, there's the Snap Kitchen signs. They have a corner space in that shopping center, so they have a signable facade facing the road, and then one kind of facing where 202 would be overpass there.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So they wanted to put a sign on each side there.
Okay.
The sign on the side is, they were proposing slightly smaller because they have a smaller facade on that side. So what they would like to do is the facade is going to be, they'd like to cover that in it's a faux wood, like planks going across there. And then on top of that, the Snap Kitchen logo, which is channel letters that illuminate white, and then they have returns that are chrome, I believe it is. So there's like a chrome and a wood look going on there with the white letters that illuminate. And then they have, again, the lettering is a little larger than usual on these. And the reason for that, too, is Snap Kitchen has an interesting logo with the kitchen being so small and everything. So they're trying to compensate somewhat for that to see if they could get a little larger sign than, say, 1 foot high Snap, because then Kitchen would be tiny. And that's what they have to work with. They can't mess around with the corporate logo. So the initial proposal is the S in Snap is 2 feet, 3 inches. On the front sign, and I'm sorry, it is the same size sign on each side. Just the one facade's a little smaller.
Again, you have a temporary banner up there?
And the temporary banner's on the front.
Yeah.
Right.
Again, is that representation of what you're proposing here?
That one's actually a little smaller.
You know what? I think that looks pretty good, actually.
I drove by, took some pictures of it.
Yeah, David was by, too.
Yeah.
Any idea what that is?
The letter height on the S on that is an inch and a half. An inch, I keep saying that, foot and a half instead of 2 feet.
Okay, so 18-inch on the S?
On the S, on that temporary banner, yeah.
You know, we've had, in the last few months, quite a few of those businesses come in.
Yeah.
For signage as that complex starts to get filled.
Yes, I think it's just, I like the banner sign, yes, size, yes, this is a lot larger.
Yeah.
Right. Starbucks is 14-inch.
Yeah. And what do we do for Bulldog?
Bulldog's 12 and, a little over a foot.
Yeah.
12.5. And Bernie Robbins, who the neighbor, the B and the R in Bernie Robbins are 24, and then the smaller case letters are 16. So.
What was the other restaurant, Time?
First Watch is actually a little over 20.
And this is, I'm sorry, what is
18
this?
For the S. I don't know.
I think
I don't really have a problem. I think what looks
you think
on
the banner looks good right now.
I do.
18 inches is
good. David agrees with me.
Yeah, 18. Yep, I like it, 18.
Yeah, I think any bigger than that, you're going to bury the other stores in signage. And, you know, we want to try to keep some consistency.
Right.
So, you're right with that? You're okay?
Oh, yeah. We can do the 18-inch on that, yeah.
And what about, does the developer itself has any say in basically your signage height?
The developer signs off, you know, we get them to approve everything, or the owner of the shopping center, the owner of the property, and they did approve.
They approved
that one.
Okay.
On the larger one, yeah.
Okay.
The 2-foot one. They were okay with that, so we thought, okay, well, Snap Kitchen wanted to throw that out there.
Well, everyone always comes in to see, you know,
yeah.
I understand that. I'd come in and ask for the largest sign I can, and then just see what happens.
Yeah.
Let the chips fall to 18 inches.
Yeah. I mean, that building's pretty close to the road.
It's going to be visible.
Oh, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Yeah, no question about it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I hadn't seen it since the banner went up. I stopped there on the way here.
Yeah, looks good, don't you think? Yeah.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
May I make a comment?
Sure.
It's actually a facade change in color.
Mm-hmm.
With this sign behind there, we went to a lot of trouble to make sure that building was very uniform with all the other buildings that is on Provco's property there. Now we're going to allow one tenant to fit a different color on the face of that building so he can put his sign up.
Actually, I think Bulldog, I think, changed kind of a wood look too. Do you remember that, Greg? Yeah, I think Bulldog and I think First Watch also may have done something like that. Yeah, I think I'm pretty sure. I don't know if you have that right there. You can take a quick look or not.
Just wanted to make sure, and it would be nice for the board to have mm-hmm. something in writing from the building owner mm-hmm. stating that this is approved, somewhat like Spread Eagle used to do or does. They approve the signs, and they actually help them present then.
Okay.
Because if you approve this and it gets up and there's a question.
Right.
It's nice to have that on record.
But Ray, I think too, looking at the building, and I don't know if we have an over a full shot of that. I think like Bernie Robbins, I think their sign is up against brick. And I think some portion of that building has like the almost like the aluminum cutouts where he's going to place the wood over top of that. So I think there's not full consistency within that center and that new building, that new complex.
All right, the other thing is I don't see a height on this. Are we going to question the height of the...
Yeah, we'll just...
Yeah.
I think it's consistent with the other ones, but let's make sure with Greg that...
Yeah, I would have thought that. I would have thought the developer would have allowed... that would have created signage space not to exceed 15
right.
feet. Do you know how high it is?
It is over 15 feet where they put the facade.
But is your sign?
Oh, the sign is... I think I... Oh, wait, here it is. I think that's 41. I think the bottom.
Isn't it the same height as the other signage spaces that have been allocated for sign in the other?
Yeah.
It doesn't look high, but I don't know.
I think First Watch had that same kind of.
These photos might
have.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it looks like it's.
It's going to be.
Okay.
With Bernie Robbins next to it and then Starbucks next to that.
So probably the bottom, or the, it's probably right around 15 feet, maybe middle of the sign band is probably around 15 feet.
Yeah.
Maybe a little higher than that, but.
Of course, we have
like right on the edge.
The dermatology is upstairs.
Dermatology, yeah. They already went to zoning, didn't they? Did they get that approved? Dermatology?
On the second floor.
Oh, you don't know?
Okay.
Well, we always say it's a unique location.
Yes.
So the snap kitchen will line up with the Bernie Robbins next to it, with the sign band to line up and the letters to line up with that, with the center on that.
I just think is that aside from what's permitted, but as long as aesthetically it's consistent with the other sign, it's like basically from the same, the height is equivalent to Starbucks.
Yeah.
It's basically, it's paralleling, it's symmetrical with the building itself, which I think is important.
Well, and actually with the snap brought down in size, it should fit around the same, in the same, it'll be centered like Starbucks is.
Yeah.
Can we make sure that?
It would look a little, yeah, more so than on the rendering that you have there, the application, right?
Well, Greg, we'll put that in our motion, that it can't exceed 15.
Well, what if it does?
Come on back, we'll figure something out.
But what about the others? I mean, did we measure everybody?
I gotta believe that we checked on those.
I don't have any recollection of discussing it. I think I made the assumption that since this area had been carved out by the builder for signage, that was done.
That's, Cindy, we have some issues for that building already going to zoning, asking for zoning appeals for signage over 15 feet.
That's the dermatology office, right? They're asking for like 30, no, 20.
Anything over 15 feet has to go to zoning.
Okay, so we need to know.
So they would just have to have a max height of 15 feet from grade.
Okay.
All right.
And maybe if Greg can show that, if you bring us in something that shows
that. I'll get a measure on that and do an elevation.
I think all the others have shown that or wouldn't have gotten past us.
Okay, that's what I want to know.
Right.
Okay, yeah.
All right, good.
Okay, so we'll confirm that before you actually hang the sign.
Yep, okay, good.
Yeah, with that assumption.
So 15-foot height max with an elevation, showing that and all the dimensions of the height.
Okay. All right, as far as that backdrop goes, the wood plank backdrop, I mean, refresh my memory, but that's what I kind of remember. First watch coming in.
Yeah, I thought they were like, are they on metal?
I think on a wood type.
Bulldog. I wish I could remember. I wish I'd kept my bulldog pictures.
She had like a wood background with a logo and bulldog yoga next to it.
I thought I can bring it up on my phone.
So there's been some, Bernie Robbins is just plugged on the wall. Starbucks is pretty much plugged on there.
Maybe I can see bulldog images.
Okay. All right. Again, while Cindy's looking at that, why don't we just jump over to the ground sign? That should be pretty
good. I had some other photographs of that shopping center. I was seeing if I had them on my phone.
Oh, okay.
That's what you were talking about.
But. Yeah. Greg, it looks like you're going to get on the ground sign. You're going to get a panel.
Yeah, there's a space there. So they'll just, it's just a matching tenant panel on that.
Okay.
Just the letters.
And they're aluminum, I believe, right? Aluminum panels. Okay.
There was a rendering.
Opaque and all that.
It's in the wrong spot. But
okay. All right, good. All right. And again, address, number, we'll make sure of that. And actually, I think there's side doors on those buildings too. So we put one on the front and one on the side. Yes. I think it's like the, might be a side entrance on the western side of the building.
I don't remember one, but I'll look.
Yeah, take a look. I think where you're going to put your other sign.
Okay.
Yeah, I think there may be one there.
Did we confirm the letter height for Starbucks?
That's what we're discussing.
Yeah.
I can't remember that. But,
Starbucks letter height, I have it down as 14 inch.
Oh, the letter. Oh, I'm sorry. The letter height.
Yeah, letter height.
I think you meant the height.
So I'm sorry. So where are we going with the?
We're going to eight. We're going to
18 on the S. So he's getting a little bit bigger, and he needs to do that in order for the kitchen and snap kitchen to be a little more prominent.
They put a picture of their place.
So. Yeah. So he was asking for 27.
Yeah.
He's going down to 18. So,
all right, it's a compromise.
Okay, it'll still meet the square footage requirements.
Right.
He's allowed 47. The sign he proposed was 42, and we're shrinking it down even more. So he's fine there. So, okay.
I do.
Okay, so the big question is, again, the height, just you're going to check that out?
We'll get some measurements on that and work up an elevation when we submit the paperwork on that and make sure it's at 15 or under.
Okay. All right. All right. Anything else we should know on the building, Greg? Or that's it?
No.
Okay. You guys all right?
Yeah. Okay. I can't find it right now.
Okay. All right. Ray, you're all right? Okay. All right. Lisa, you want to take this one?
Sure.
Thanks.
Matter of VRB 2016-24, I move that we approve the signage is submitted as long as the total height does not exceed 15 feet above ground level and the letters do not exceed 18 inches.
Okay. Do I hear a second?
Second.
Okay. Second. All in favor?
I mean, aye.
Okay. All right. Thanks, Greg. And you'll be in touch with the...
Okay.
Okay, good. And Greg, I guess you want to make up a new sketch, too, for the files, showing the 18-inch letters
and
all?
Yeah, I'll have that complete in the, as part of the application.
Okay, great. All right. Thanks, Greg.
Thanks.
Okay. Next on tonight's agenda is DRB 2016-24, the application of State Farm Insurance at 936 County Line Road in Bryn Mawr for a freestanding sign. How you doing?
Good.
Good.
Sorry I was late.
No problem.
Nick Capatos from Sign Pros. The owner couldn't be here this evening, so that's why I'm coming at the last minute, but hopefully I can answer any questions.
All right. Okay, so it looks like...
Was there existing? I apologize if the one drawing looks a little dark. I think there was an existing sign out there.
There was existing? Okay.
Yeah, and it's a little hard to see. It looks like at one point there was a little wooden sign there. So the idea would be to just remove that wooden sign and put this typical State Farm type of sign with the agent's name on the bottom of it.
Okay.
But it would be illuminating.
Yeah, it's a tough location.
I know.
Yeah, you know what? Just speak right in the mic there.
Yes.
So everybody hears you at home. So, okay, why don't you just kind of tell us what you have in mind and...
Well, this is, the drawing is actually from the national manufacturer. Everbright is who manufactures these signs. They hire local contractors to put the signs up. So what we have here is just a typical 4-foot by 5-foot illuminated sign, 8-foot overall height. It would be simply 2 footings dug, sign put in the ground, electric run over to it to replace the existing sign that's out there. That's about it. It's internally illuminated. They've been using mostly LEDs now, so I think it's LED lighting inside. Mm-hmm.
I think the sign looks fine. It looks a little high to me.
So that's what I was thinking, too.
Well, that's something that, you know, I think that this was, like I said, a typical, whatever the board's opinion, I think, is going to be fine. If you look, and like I said, the one picture is very dark. You can see we could easily lower it down if you thought that was important. 8 feet seems high to me, too, for only 4 foot by 3 foot.
Yeah,
sign.
Yeah.
It's not a very big sign.
Is there an issue if you're going to be making a right-hand turn onto County Line Road from Interesting
I don't believe Road? That's just the driveway there. I don't think it's any site triangle issues or anything like that.
We could ask, we'll ask the township to come out, the police to do it, just to check that location out, make sure nothing's going to block the sight lines.
Yeah, I don't believe it's in the site triangle.
Okay, so before you put it up. Yeah, have them come out. Traffic study.
So that's illuminated. Are there any residents on the neighboring buildings?
I think it's a combination of offices and residential mix. Mm-hmm. I think it's a mixed-use location.
Yeah.
So how bright will the sign be?
I think the sign could be turned off at the end of each day. Do you have an ordinance that dictates how long a sign's on in the evenings?
Do we? I don't.
Not really.
No.
But our major issue is that the background has to be opaque at night.
It looks like you've indicated that, right? Only the logo, State Farm, Jim D'Angelo?
Only the logo illuminates, yes. I've done other signs in the town.
In Radnor.
In Radnor,
all
I just did
mascot.
Malvern Bank. Mm-hmm. Was Malvern, is that in
Down on that.
Well, it was one of their branches, and it was...
320.
We cut a metal face. I was actually working for another sign company. Mm-hmm. We cut the face for them, and only the letters lit up, and I think that's this manufacturer will match that. So it will be it's not going to illuminate much, only the letters are lighting up.
So it's just super bright in this photo.
It is, I apologize.
Well,
the background's dark, and the picture is bright.
Oh, okay. I guess the bottom white panel, though, it's going to be white, right, with the black lettering. I
mean, white aluminum with it'll be probably the black-white material that lights white at night, so it'll be a milky white.
So wait,
it's black in the daytime, and at nighttime it'll illuminate white.
You mean his name is black in the daytime and white, and the white background will go to black at night.
It'll turn black at night.
Yeah, because they can mask that. So, yes.
So how are you going to work around the black lettering?
it'll turn to white.
No, it'll turn to white. Okay.
It'll be a little bit lighter than, there are other signs like that.
Gotcha.
What do you think the height should be? Do you think 6 foot? I mean, I'm 6 foot tall, 4 foot high, 2 feet off the ground.
No, I think that's too tall. I'm thinking five.
Five, there's only a foot off the ground. You can't do any landscaping or any plantings if you're only a foot off the ground.
I really think that it needs to be brought down to about the height of the width.
Think the overall size is maybe a little big?
Yeah, I think the whole thing is just a little in your face, but because it's very visible and you're in a very small part of the community, you're not out on Lancaster Avenue,
I'd rather be a little higher to put plantings and smaller for the overall size, if that works better.
I'll tell you what, if you look at Lululemon Athletica in town, and they've got a low ground sign, and I think it really looks nice.
It does.
As people are driving down, it's kind of at eye level.
It is.
There's not a lot of ground, though, in front of this, if you can see. There's not a lot of
setback here.
There's not much setback at all.
The other problem is the setback itself. It has to be 10 foot off the road. I don't know if you're going to meet that requirement.
There's no way to meet that requirement.
I know. That's the other problem.
Is this a variance proceeding or is this a historic board? What am I in front of?
Well, you're not in front of the historic board.
I apologize for not paying attention.
Not HARB.
Yeah, not HARB. But we need to get, it's got to be 10 foot off the cartway, so.
Are you able to grant a variance at this board?
We can't.
We can't, yeah.
You recommend? Is that how it works?
Yeah.
Well, I think what we do is we say we approve the design of the sign and the size, but we can't tell zoning. You have to go to zoning, I think, right?
What about the fact that there was a pre-existing sign here? Does that make a difference?
Yeah, we have no grandfather.
No.
Mm-mm. But if you can get it back closer to the building, that would be better. Also.
I mean, it looks like the sidewalk's about 4 feet.
Yeah, so 4 feet.
Yeah.
So now you're like.
And it looks like the building's 10.
Yeah. It looks like that little front strip is like 8 feet, if that.
Yeah, if that. Yeah.
Jim, I don't know whether. Is it Jim? I'm sorry.
I'm Nick.
Or Nick, I'm sorry.
Jim is the.
Jim's
the. The guy who didn't show
state,
up.
The State Farm guy.
It's not helping me out here.
Nick, I don't know if you can just revisit that whole.
Well, what about let's do height and square footage? Do you guys want at least a comment on that and maybe see what we can do there and then see about
get around that 10 foot off the cartway. Yeah. So I don't know if there's another type of sign that's better for that building than a ground sign.
Well, there looks to be a sign further. This is terrible. I didn't visit the site. I'm sorry. I'm third party on all this.
Yeah.
I mean, it is considered a hardship. Do you grant variances?
No.
You do not grant variances?
We don't.
Oh, I mean, this board doesn't.
You can go to zoning hearing board.
So this is just a design.
Yes.
Yeah. I think part of the issue thing is like why this thing just stands out, even with the rendering, is the fact is that there's no setback. So whatever you do, even if you lower it to 5 feet, the maximum height, and whatever width it's going to be, it's still going to stand out.
Yeah.
Because you're right on top of the sidewalk. You're right on top of the road. So I would.
But Nick, let me ask you this: does this Jim D'Angelo have a sign up currently?
He's got nothing.
He's got nothing.
I don't think he's going to rent the building if he doesn't get a sign.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, but he's in there operating.
I don't know.
You don't know that.
I have nothing. I don't believe there's any existing signage at all.
Because what I was going
to
say.
I'm assuming it was already pre-approved. I didn't talk to the zoning officer. I don't know. Do you guys have Mercantile licenses?
Can he change? Is he mandated by State Farm to have this sign?
He has to have identification.
Right.
Now there was going to be some identification on the glass door that I guess says his name on the glass door.
But should he have like a monument type of a sign in lieu?
But once again, how do you get the setback?
Yeah. It still has to be the 10 foot setback.
Yeah.
What about, can you mount a sign on this, on the porch side?
I wondered about that, but it's hard to tell from the photograph what exactly
that
is.
It's a poor photograph.
So, okay. Nick, what I was going to say is.
I mean, the only thing in the photograph, I have another picture where, do you guys regulate graphics on the windows?
We do.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're allowed up to 20%.
Okay.
So you can do that. Actually, you know what, Nick, why don't you put the, so people at home can see, and the people in the audience, just lay your plan out on the table there so people can see what we're talking about.
Well, that's the.
Okay. So, what am I seeing?
That's something different that they submitted. It don't look like it's part of the package, but the idea was to put the vinyl graphics on the window. But you know.
Well, that's a better. That would make life a lot easier for us.
Yeah.
So you know.
Yeah.
So you guys wouldn't have the ability to approve. Why wouldn't the zoning officer tell us that the sign wouldn't be approved? Why would I be in front of this board?
Why wouldn't they?
Yes.
Oh, wait. You mean going forward? If you.
No. Why would I be in front of this board if the sign doesn't even meet the ordinance?
I'm not sure. But can I ask Ray something?
Well,
Ray, if they came in for a monument sign, not for a window sign, and he's showing us a plan for a window sign, can we approve the window sign and not the monument? Or should he come back?
Yeah, I think you could as an alternative. If the monument is not going to work, if this the second option would be, we've done that before.
Okay.
Okay, so like a second option type of thing?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think this was part of the plan because I think he was just going to put his name on the window.
Right.
The applicant that I have only says about this monument sign, but if you think it's a not permitted use...
Well, it's just not going to meet code and, you know...
Okay, so the height doesn't even matter. But could I ask that question? If we were to come back for a monument or a sign, how high would you recommend and how much, what square footage do you think for this property?
Well, you're...
Put you on the spot.
I honestly don't think it's worth going down that road.
You don't think it would ever be approved?
We can.
Well, they have to approve it and then we can discuss that.
But, you know, it is important for us to remember that if zoning approves it and we haven't said what we would like to see, then they get what zoning approves. So we should say what we, what as a design review board, we'd like to see for sign dimensions, because otherwise...
That's what I was getting at.
They tell you you can come in here with an 8x4, you know, we're like, I don't know where you put it, but...
Yeah, I appreciate it. I think your 8 foot is correct. The question is 6'3" x 4" instead of 4x5".
I think 3x4 would be much more appropriate. No, it fits in the scale of the neighborhood better.
Yeah.
Okay.
3x4.
Here's another idea. I'm not sure if you're able to do it, but in addition to...
5 foot overall height then? Let me do 5 foot height. Were you thinking 5 foot high, 3 foot, so 2 foot off the ground?
The height would be determined by traffic safety and community development for sight line.
Okay. If it's not in a sight triangle.
It doesn't matter what, we will determine whether it's in or not and then give you a height, but the height is not to exceed the maximum height of code, which is 8 foot.
Which is 8 foot already.
So we recommend 3x4. I have a question, though. You know, where this, you have this little porch that comes out? Could you do a sign hanging from there?
Or actually, affix it right on top of...
Affix it right to that side, so it could be seen from the street.
Yeah, because it's coming, because you go straight up on County Line Road, so you're going to have that...
I think it'll be visible maybe from one direction. I don't know how visible the other direction, but if that's a compromise...
Nick, I think at this point, we're probably not going to achieve anything tonight. Why don't you tell Mr. D'Angelo, if he wants, with township approval, he can put up a 30-day temporary banner. Why don't you revisit the location, try to hammer out a new plan, and come to us next month?
Do you think we can get approval for the vinyl this evening?
I think we can approve the vinyl.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's take a better look at it. You're allowed in that area, C1 zoning, 20 square feet.
Of the window area or the facade area?
Window.
The window.
Window.
So 20 square feet?
Excuse me, I'm sorry, 20%.
So if a window is a 4x5 window...
You get 20% of that.
20% of that 20, so four square feet.
Yeah.
All right, you want to look at that, Ann? I mean, if I make sure that that conforms.
Mm-hmm. Oh, there, okay.
Yeah, I'm fine with that.
Mm-hmm.
So the door's okay, nice on the glass door to put his
name.
And things like that, and then on there.
Mm-hmm.
Now you're gonna love me. I have one more.
I do apologize. I drove an hour to get here. I was at graduation. My brother just graduated from Rowan.
Oh, and you got all the way here?
From there to here.
You're a good guy.
This is crazy. I don't know what this is or where this is located. Is this the side of the alleyway? Is this
it's
not a road?
I think
there?
It is.
Yeah.
I think it's down his drive, right?
It is, because look at the front photograph. It's, it's brick.
If you say no,
I know. You're just here.
Great salesman.
Are these lit?
No, this would be vinyl.
It's really
on
not
these.
A corner property.
No. Even
windows, where you if you can see, they're actually with mullions in them, so I wouldn't even.
How would you be doing that?
Who's going to see it?
Yeah, and it's not a corner property. Mm-hmm. I mean, we'll allow signage on the corner property. It's not a corner property.
It's a narrow driveway. Here's,
Mr. Chairman,
yes.
I think at this point, we can't do option all the way to Z.
Right, right.
A and B isn't bad, but let's don't go to... I think if you wanted to do that, you should have had your application right.
Yeah. Not my application.
I understand. I think you're a good guy to come help him out.
Yes.
And
so I'll just verify that matches 20%. This application goes back in front of your zoning officer, who will review this based on your recommendation.
Mm-hmm.
So the ground sign at this point, forget it.
I'm putting down your standards.
If you get it through zoning,
if you get it through zoning, 4x5 is our, what did we say, 4x5 is 3x4. 3x4, 3x4.
3x4, 5 feet high, height depending on the traffic sign.
No, not 5 feet high, traffic will determine that.
Okay. I'm putting 5 on my drawing, but I'll make a notation of it.
Okay.
Okay. All right. So the window is that full graphic on the right. Or not.
Yeah,
it looks like there's something.
It's the State Farm with the three circles that don't have them. They don't have graphics in them anymore. If anybody noticed, they don't do that anymore. And then the little bottom tagline that just says providing insurance and the financial services. And then if you see on the right hand side,
that's the door.
Jim's name and I guess his office hours that he wanted to put on there.
Mm-hmm.
That's permitted to put all that.
Mm-hmm. Okay. We can approve that.
Provided it meets
yes.
the 20%.
Right.
20%.
Okay.
Yeah, I can verify that.
Okay.
I'll put the sizes on the windows.
Give it a shot.
Okay. In the matter of DRB 2016-24, State Farm Insurance at 936 County Line Road, I move that we accept the application for the vinyl sign on the window not to exceed 20% of the window space, and just as presented. And additionally, if this application is approved, or the application for relief is approved by zoning, the ground side should not exceed 3x4 feet. And the height of the sign will be determined by traffic regulations.
Okay.
That got it?
Yeah. Jim, or
no
Nick?
No signs on the windows.
And the illumination's allowed on that prop? There is a be internally illuminated is allowed, but only the letters light up?
Only the letters can light up. Everything else reverses to black.
Okay.
Sounds good.
Nick, you're all right with that?
Yeah.
Okay. So you understand the process?
Somewhat.
Okay. Well, Peggy will help you out, or Ray will help you out.
I'm used to historic boards, not design reviews.
Okay. All right. Okay. Do we hear a second on that? Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Ray, you're okay? All right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you. Next is DRB 2016-25, the application of One Lead Incorporated, 1122 County Line Road in Rosemont, for a ground sign. Okay. And even though this is just down the street from the last applicant, it's zoned differently. So we have a different set of, that's not you guys? Okay, all right. So One Lead Incorporated is not here?
Oh.
We are here. All right, step right up.
I lead.
Oh, well, I lead, sorry.
Okay. I am sorry, I'm third party on this as well.
Okay.
I'm filling in for someone who actually no longer works with us.
Okay.
So. I have not.
We still have the client, right?
Yes.
All right. Okay. Your name is?
My name is Jennifer, and I'm from Elmar.
Okay. All right. So this is, as you kind of make the bend on County Line Road, coming off of Route 30, where the McDonald's is to the left.
Yeah.
Make the right, and then
there's
kind of heavy.
Around.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's on the right.
Right by the Sunoco.
Yeah. It was a Villanova. Something that tied in with the university, I believe.
Wait,
there
where
before.
Is it when you're going,
remember we approved.
It's right by the Sunoco. So if you go hit McDonald's, right by St. Thomas Church, you take that right.
Yeah.
It's on the right side,
got it,
around the bend.
Sorry about that.
Yeah.
It's like Cookie or Subway Sandwich.
Yeah, Insomnia Cookies.
Okay. Place.
We know them. Yeah. Okay, Jennifer, can you walk us through?
It's those? The post would be just refurbished. They'd be sanded, painted white. So those stay the same. And then there's going to be two aluminum panels for eye lead, and then two aluminum panels below it. So it's not a double-sided sign. It's going to be face screwed on each side. So the poles would be between them.
Mm-hmm.
Jennifer, the biggest problem is, even though it's just down the street from the last applicants, in that location, it's a residential location.
Okay.
He's more of a commercial location. You're residential, and you're only allowed 15 square feet. Because
total?
It's total. So you're over. You're 24.16. Mm-hmm.
Right. It looks like there's one sign there, the blue white, I believe.
Yes.
Yeah.
See, that came before our board, so that was approved. But
it was 5 feet in width.
Yeah. And
so it's probably 15. It's 5x2, right? 2x5. Five by three.
Yeah, I remember
that'd
when that
15,
came in,
yes.
So you're over by a lot.
Okay.
And
yes,
again, I would almost say, just looking at this application, you're probably going to have to go back to the drawing board and figure out how to incorporate those two signs into one and keep it at 15
feet max.
Okay,
so everything has to be on the 30 by 60? They're allowed?
However you can figure it out, as long as it's not over 15 square feet, you can, whatever works. But that's just, unfortunately, it's just a problem in that area.
So that's overall, so can they only do one side then? Or is it 15 on each side?
No, 15 on each side.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, if you want it back, if each side has it.
If you want to do one on each side, then you'd be able to do it. But
your total square footage on the one side can't exceed 15 square feet. And Your height requirement on that is 8 feet from grade, so you can go up to 8 feet. It does.
I know, it does seem tall.
It's kind of a tall, narrow sign. They keep it at 15.
Right, it does look a little silly with the...
It looks silly with those long posts under it, doesn't it?
Right, it does.
But you can bring it down.
Oh, certainly, yeah.
I think it'd be nicer, you know, while you're redesigning it, if you don't mind thinking about bringing it down, I think it'd be nice for the neighborhood.
Yeah, again, I don't know, people tend to want to put them high.
I know, I don't...
And yeah, it's not really at eye level when you're driving by in a car.
But the blue and white, that's existing, right? The blue and white?
Evidently, the new one's going to replace it.
Yeah.
But I mean, right now, it's...
I don't know if it's still up or whether it's down.
I still remember, I mean, it wasn't really that bad aesthetically.
Well, it must be a new business in there or whatever, so... So that sign's going to go.
No, but my point is that the the height of the former, either the current and or former sign, it wasn't that bad for that.
Well, it didn't meet code.
Yeah.
So evidently, the previous tenant wanted that.
From a height standpoint.
It was okay, yeah.
It was okay.
Okay, but like I say, Jennifer, I think unfortunately you're going to have to come back.
Okay.
And work with, you know, the property owners or whoever. But, and everything's in our code book too. You can look online. So you can, you know, if you have any other questions.
So should the post stay as is, or do you want them to be a little lower?
That's for you to figure out, you know, yeah. So I think our board would be in agreement. If anything, maybe you can lower it down. It might aesthetically look a little bit better. But that's your call. Yeah.
All right.
And I mean, if I don't know if you want to do two separate signs or try to incorporate one sign, you know, one board with the two names on there, or two separate.
Wait, you could put two signs on the property?
Well, you really, it's really only one sign. They're so darn close together, though.
Could you maybe do the eye lead sign and then do a rider right below it?
And do a what below?
A rider. Just a one tenant panel, not maybe 6 inches in height, just saying their name.
Oh, saying Arch Street Press?
Yeah.
That would look nice.
Rather than a full sign.
Are they related businesses? Would they be amenable to that?
I don't know.
Oh, yeah, you could, if you don't exceed the 15, is it 15 square feet?
Yes.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, the code's a little tough to figure out because it says no more than one sign shall be placed on premises.
Yes.
Oh. So does that constitute two signs or does that constitute one sign with two panels?
It's about to become one sign with two panels.
Yeah, that's what I kind of think too, yeah. I think what they're kind of saying, you can't put a ground sign and a sign on the building as such.
Sign. Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, okay. All right. So we can get you back here next month, but you would have to get all your plans into the township before
the
18th. The business. Mm-hmm. Actually, by May 18th. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. 18th, you saw it.
Because I had to come here for June for my own job.
Okay.
So.
June 8th is our next meeting. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. So I don't think that's going to happen by the 18th.
Okay. Again, if there's a hardship down there, with township approval, the property owner or tenant could put up a temporary banner, but it has to go through community development for approval. So I don't know what what their course of action is now, if they're refitting a building or what. So,
what do they have to do if they want a temporary banner?
Well, if he wants to put a temporary banner, he has to go before community development.
Okay.
Just check in with the office, show them a plan before you get it made up, and they'll either approve it or not approve it. For a temporary banner. It's a 30-day temporary banner.
30 days.
Yeah, 30 days. Again, I think the 10-foot off cartway, we probably just make sure that it's 10-foot off the cartway. It should be. We approved it before.
I know.
If not, we'd have to
move it back.
Move it closer to the building, yeah.
Yeah. And then just, you know, come in with the type of materials you're going to use and the lighting and all that kind of stuff, too. So.
Okay.
All right.
All right. Thank you.
So you're all right with that?
Yeah.
Okay,
thank you.
Good. Okay, so David, you want to take this one?
Oh,
I guess we'll just, that'll be a continuation. Is that the correct terminology? Okay.
So in the matter of the application for DRB 2016-25, iLead Inc., you will be coming back with a revised sign to present with a new application, hopefully the following month.
Okay. Does a whole new application have to be submitted with another fee?
You know what, you could.
No fee, just another application.
Just the artwork and information is fine.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Do I hear a second on that?
Second.
Okay. God bless.
Bless
all
you.
In favor?
Aye.
Is that your second?
She sneezed it in.
Yeah. All right. Next tonight is DRB 2016-26, the application of 181 to 183 East Lancaster Avenue, LLC. zone under Wayne Business Overlay District for facade renovation.
Yes.
Hello there.
Hi.
Hi.
This looks nice.
Okay.
Good evening. Carl Gatilla, 3GHC Architects.
All right.
Rob Shirley with the Provco Group.
Good to have you here. All right, so this was formerly Art Forster's frame store. And if you remember last month.
It's going to be Velvet Shoestring.
Velvet Shoestring is going in there.
Or showroom or something like that, yeah.
Right. Okay, so why don't you walk us through what you have in mind?
Looks cool.
Okay, so basically, the idea is to take out the old storefront, which is this configuration, which is non-tempered glass, non-compliant ADA access, and replace it with a new metal and glass storefront going all the way across straight. We'll create a new little vestibule for the upstairs tenant, which is very crowded in there. We'll be able to get an ANSI-compliant door for handicapped access, take the old storefront away, which is really falling apart. So this will be black aluminum, clear glass. It'll have a little bit of a granite base on the bottom, like a little curb. Then we're going to take the existing, there's some very nice existing precast concrete right here, which is painted right now. So we'll clean that off and restore that to what it was, which is kind of like an Indiana limestone. So that'll match all of the precast accent pieces above. We're retaining this entire, all the decorative brickwork will stay. Then we'll put a couple of new decorative wall sconces, which are basically this. It's a nice bronze fixture. We used a similar one in 775 Lancaster, which we just did. So that'll throw a nice little light. There's an accent piece. And essentially, that's it. We're not asking for the signage with this application.
Right. They were in last month. Or
the awning. So that's a separate. So that's basically it in a nutshell.
What's happening to the meter? Just stays there? Isn't there a meter right
there? Yeah, there's a little meter right here. Yeah, we're going to have to relocate that.
Oh, you are going to relocate it?
We're going to have to. It's kind of, I think
I know,
it's right
it's
about
ugly.
It's in a terrible spot.
Yeah.
It's like, I think it's right there.
Yeah.
So I don't know if you knew about that.
Is that electric? What meter?
Are you able to do that?
You know what? I thought it was.
It might be gas. It could be water. I don't know.
Water? Yeah. Makes that
call.
So it's right in the way.
No, I think that's gases.
I don't know. Do you know what it is? It's gas?
Gas meter.
Maybe
it is. We're going to move it.
Ray wants to say
something. It's a gas meter, yes. Gas meter. You also have a fire department connection, a 5-inch Storch connection going up there, and you'll need to place a Knox box on there somewhere. So I think some of your work, you may have to adjust some of the light fixtures and things to accommodate the new requirements going in there. You don't show any of these details on your picture.
You're right, we don't. Let me get with you on that. We'll take care of it.
Okay.
I think
Yeah.
It's such a great looking building. You don't notice it until you're going to draw attention to it this way, the details above.
I've looked at it for years. I didn't realize it was actually all three of those are one building with the same design.
Yeah.
It's so gunked up with awnings.
I know.
Awnings.
It's pretty.
But it's a really good looking.
Ray, what's wrong with, the sconces are a problem? They're going to create a problem?
Depending upon how wide that pillar is, you need to have on that pillar a 5-inch Storch connection at 36 inches with a 12-inch plate. You need a Knox box at 5 foot to the bottom of the box, which is an 8-inch high box.
Mm-hmm.
And you're going to need a horn strobe outside to show when the alarm goes off. So I think from what I'm looking at here, it might be a little busy on that one pillar. I just want everybody to be aware that, so we don't get into this thing of approving, and if they're going to move the gas meter, can't go inside the building, it's going to have to go in the face of the building. So are we going to add the gas meter to that pillar? Just want everybody to be aware that that's where that needs to be, if that's
right.
Yeah.
If you determine to approve something.
Is that for sure that the gas meter can't go inside the building?
Absolutely.
Oh, why is that? I mean,
because they don't want gas leaking in the building anymore than that.
Oh, okay. So there are some that still have gas meters in the building.
They will be moved outside as they're starting to do all over.
But you can put them lower down, right?
Yeah.
Well, they have to be a minimum of 12 inches off the ground for for code clearance.
Well, so maybe
so
here,
start we? Adding that up as we go.
Yeah, so you want to put it in front of one of those.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then we'll raise the light up a little bit to make sure we have enough for the FTC connection. And we'll get a strobe out there.
I mean, ask you this.
Paint the meter, like have it pinned in somewhere, right?
Yeah, we'll paint it in. It'll be in front of the precast.
No. It has to be metal. It has to be.
Yep. Well, can you enclose it? Can you basically just put a box around it?
What did you say? You can't paint the meters?
Can't paint the meters.
Too late. I already painted mine at home.
Oh, my lips are sealed.
Yeah, they look tattered
looking. They
look
terrible.
Yeah, you know.
I know.
I still think that location works.
I think that location will work.
Yeah. Let me ask you this. Is it mandatory you put the lights up or not?
No, it was just
Yeah,
they're nice looking.
Maybe really more squares.
I'm
like
keeping this. I think I want to do this someplace else. They're very nice. Yeah.
Okay. Well, mm-hmm. Margaret Quo has somewhat similar ones, it looks like, on her building. It's a little smaller. I don't think they're as long, but.
Hers are a little different. These are.
Yeah, they're not quite
like,
as long.
No.
These are like, you know.
These are very nice. These are good
really
looking.
Cool. Yeah. If you've seen them lit up on 775, they look great at night.
Well,
will it be at the same height as the building, as the restaurant next door?
The Margaret Quo building?
Yeah, will they be at the same?
Actually, hers look higher, I think. So we're probably going to raise ours up to make room for the fire department connection anyway. So
her building is so different that I don't think it matters as much as long as you're consistent with everything in the brick side. Hers is such a different design.
Yeah, it's so different.
I don't think it'll show.
And will there be is there going to be an awning as well or no?
The awning was approved last month.
Okay, yeah. So that's
but is she
so
doing?
Gonna
is she going to do the awning?
She was in last month.
I know. I didn't know if she was going ahead with the awning. The
she
tenant.
Is, I think, right?
I think that's her interest.
So,
okay.
Unless she changes her mind.
Okay. Yeah.
They didn't know we were doing this.
So we wouldn't.
So this might. She might say, even though the awning is good because it blocks all the light, and sun, you know, from
because it's sunny. And then the signage can be on the awning, then we won't need to do this.
Yeah.
Awkward.
I'd imagine she wants to keep consistency with the other building in town too that she's got.
Yeah.
You know, it's kind of almost her logo at this point. That striped awning.
Yep.
So.
All right,
so can we approve the
I think this looks
lighting,
great.
Provided it's, you know, fits within the boundaries of the building and, you know.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Where's is it 775 you've referenced?
775, where the new Starbucks is.
Down in Villanova?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You can see these fixtures on the building. If you would like to look at night, they're a great looking
fixture. I gotta learn my addresses.
Yeah.
To memorize everyone's address.
There you go. Okay, any other questions? You guys have any questions for us? You're all right?
No.
Okay. Who wants to take this one? David took the last one?
Okay.
You want to take this one? Okay.
In the matter of DRB 2016-26, I move that we approve the facade renovation as submitted, keeping in mind where the gas meter and alarm fixtures need to be placed.
Okay.
I second it.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
All right, so you'll work with the township if there's issues with the lighting. Okay.
We'll have our mechanical engineer involved anyway, so.
Okay, terrific.
Thank you.
Great.
Thank you.
Good to see you, Rob. Take care. All right.
Bye-bye.
Next is DRB 2016-27, the application of Five Below at 309 East Lancaster Avenue in Wayne for a two freestanding signs and one wall sign. Hi there.
Hi, good evening. Hi. Debbie Schulsky here on behalf of Five Below.
Great.
Also with me this evening is Glenn Fink from Five Below and Elizabeth from his office.
All right, good to have you here. Okay, so they're taking over where City Sports was.
City Sports. Yep. Correct, yes. So we're in the Wayne Square Shopping Center in the space previously occupied by City Sports. Five Below has a lease agreement to occupy that space. They're proposing a wall sign on the facade, fairly consistent with the location of the prior City Sports sign. The overall sign area is compliant with the zoning ordinance of 50 square feet. As you can see, there's blue backer and white lettering. The 50 square feet includes the entirety of the lettering and the blue backer. And again, it's kind of generally where the City Sport sign previously was. We also think it's consistent with some of the other wall signs in that center. Mm-hmm. In addition, there's two existing monument pylon signs, and they're proposing to swap out the prior city switch with the Five Below sign That'll be blue lettering and the same background that's currently there, consistent with the other tenants in that space.
Okay. Yeah, there's kind of a cream background. I think your application shows white.
We saw that. It's not supposed to be white. It's just really to kind of demark what we were, the slot.
Okay, so we'll make a cream then.
Correct.
Okay, good. All right. Okay, well, why don't we just start with the pylon signs first? So you guys take a look at those. It's really just a swap out on the two ground signs.
Mm-hmm.
And and it'll make it cream to be consistent. So.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, you all right with that?
I'm fine.
Yeah, I'm fine with the pylon signs.
And again, you probably heard a conversation before. They need to be opaque at night. So at nighttime, only five below shines through.
Correct.
Okay. All right, good. Okay. All right. Wall sign.
Okay.
All right.
So I'm going back, you know me, I'm always going back.
I know you are.
I found my city sports application, but I remember clearly the long discussion with both Chipotle and Anthony's because we wanted to be fair and have letter size that was consistent. And So Fun, Pet Value, your letters are a lot bigger than what we approved for the other tenants in that. I think you're at, 27 inches for your letters?
It's about 2 feet, 3 inches,
Or
27.
Isn't that 27? Okay, good, because I'm not. Well,
it's city sports on top of each other, so the height is actually.
I know you're thinking square footage, so the square footage is acceptable, but those are the letters are not. It's not one letter; those are two sets of letters, right? So city is probably 12. Sports is probably 12, and they got 24 total. For their logo.
Cindy, do you have Five Guys?
I'm looking for Five Guys. I'm trying to remember when Five Guys went in. Let me see.
I do have some photos of the Anthony's, and those lettering appears to be.
I'm looking for it.
So while Cindy's looking at that, you want to do a channel letter on a board, basically.
Correct.
On a backer board. So the backer board would be what type of material?
It's a metal
background. Metal?
Yes.
Okay.
It's blue metal.
And that's your corporate colors, naturally.
That is, yes.
Okay. Okay, with.
I can't remember when they came. 2012? Maybe it was 11.
All right, so you're going to have. I'm sorry, your letters are. Yeah, channel letters, internally illuminated channels. They'll appear white at night.
Guys.
Correct.
Okay, good.
Okay, Five Guys, we approved 18 inches.
18?
Mm-hmm. And I think we were pretty consistent with So Fun, Panera. I know we had long conversation with Chipotle and Anthony's, probably got the biggest letters, but I think they're 18. Only their logo was allowed to be larger.
Mm-hmm. The one thing I would say, it is a bigger building than Chipotle,
it
Anthony's.
Is bigger.
It's at least
give them
double,
more.
If not larger.
Yeah. But not 27 inches.
We're probably one of the largest storefronts. We might be the largest one in the center.
I think
you really are going to dwarf everybody else. It just the aesthetics of the whole shopping center will be out of balance with, yours being 10 inches larger than everybody else's.
As well as because of the white against the blue, further jumps out.
Yeah,
you'll
have
sure.
No problem.
Yeah. Do the other signs also have the background as well? Does Chipotle?
Five Guys mounted right on the backer board, and Panera has, some of them have backgrounds. You can see they're like, Panera has a green background that goes, and so does Pet Value. Chipotle, they have a panel that goes behind, but Mexican Grill is mounted on the, do you call that backer board?
Yeah.
I think 23 is a little
funnier.
Five Guys is 18, and it's not, the space isn't that much different.
As far as I'm aware, there's no specific ordinance requirement that governs the height of your lettering. Is that correct?
There is not.
No.
Okay.
It's more square footage and aesthetics, and go by setbacks. Of course, this is setback pretty far. Like if you put a 27-inch sign on North Wayne Avenue, it's just it's huge. Mm-hmm. Where. The store's right
on
top of the road.
I mean, when we were designing the sign, it's incurring, time and expense doing that.
We were
relying on your zoning ordinance to put together those plans.
Yeah.
Sure, I understand that. You can imagine the conversation we had with Rite Aid. They have a huge place in Wayne, and, they have a big corporate a lot of corporate behind them. They have signs. Everybody who has, you know, a national brand has a logo and signage that they'd like to have be consistent across the country, but communities.
Believe me, I understand that, but so, what I'm saying is your ordinance specifically governs the overall square footage. It doesn't govern the
I know, letter. And I find that confusing, and I would love to see us add more detail to that. But we've tried to be consistent in what's come before us.
Right. As well as we recently did it with Wawa last month.
Yeah, we just knocked made Wawa shrink down.
I mean, what I'm looking at, it's not a big picture, but it's the picture of all the stores lined up. And I just feel right now that it literally dominates the rest of the frontage. And I'm just thinking if we brought it down a little bit, that it would still stand out on its own, but be more consistent. Mm-hmm.
If I might add, I just would like to add this. We are considered the anchor tenant here, and when we talked about the size of the building, we are much wider, but we're also substantially larger in square footage.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And is that anything that you give consideration to? Is that, you know, we're the dominant tenant?
Not really.
And I say dominant, I don't mean that in a negative way.
Right.
No, but I understand what you're saying. From a real estate standpoint, I understand. From, you know, the revenue producing for that center, yes, but aesthetically, it doesn't really... I'll let the chairman speak.
Well, I think 27 is a little bit large. I think, you know, 18 is five guys. I think 18 is a little small for your spot. I'd say somewhere in between 20, 22. Believe me, people are going to see it from Route 30. If you can't see it from Route 30, you shouldn't be driving. Let me tell you, you can see that sign, no problem. No problem.
Especially the way with the white against the blue.
Yeah, that thing will pop, you know.
The prior, if you were saying the prior city sports was 12 and 12, 24.
I can't swear to that, but I think that
I'm just saying, shouldn't we at least be entitled to what was previously there?
You can, do you want to have 12-inch letters? Because we determined the letter height, this is the square footage you're allowed for your sign, but then within that sign, what's the letter height that's going to be allowed?
So.
We just don't really like the big letters. Trying to simplify it.
Still trying to keep that village, you know, Wayne's kind of a village, trying to keep that village look. We don't want to be King of Prussia Mall or, you know, some strip center, you know, McDade Boulevard or whatever. You know, we're trying to keep that village look. So we're trying to look in aesthetics and stuff like that. And yeah, 27 is going to be, compared to your neighbors, you're going to be big, you know. I think it'd just be better if you came down a little bit. There's a problem we run into all the time. Everybody wants to max out the size, you know.
And it's a combination of it's the height, but it's also these are very bold, big letters.
Yeah.
And it's different. It's more similar to five guys than the other ones that have a finer script. So it stands out for two reasons.
And again, we need to, and I think it will, but we need to make 100% sure too that it does meet the height requirement of 15 feet from grade.
I think it does.
Probably does.
Because we looked at that with City Sports.
Yeah.
And Five Guys, all of them. So you can't go above 15 feet. Mm-hmm.
We were looking at some of the other signage across the street at the Verizon appeared to be.
One by one.
Yeah. Actually, I can't see it very well.
Well, they've got that big check mark, I think, their kind of logo over there, which is large. Yeah. Right. That's. Yeah.
But they also have, you know, it's a decent amount of signage as well as a tagline below that.
Mm-hmm.
But they also have the benefit of having two signs, one on the side and one on the face that is directly up on the
So are these.
These other images.
Yeah.
This is our current prototype. So this image on the far left, second row, is our current prototype design. The balance of these locations are stores that we have recently opened, which are consistent with our prototype. And you know, these locations, typically the letter sizes are 48 inches or greater.
Yeah.
So we do recognize this is a village atmosphere.
Right, right.
You're, village environment.
Yeah.
We're not trying to be greedy.
Sure.
If we chose to, you know, comply, as Debbie had mentioned about the size of letters and the square footage, almost go to a 36-inch letter.
Right. As long as you meet the 50 square feet, you can't go any further than that. But again, if you want, you could always go to zoning for relief.
Relief for what, though?
If you want your 27-inch,
But where's the 27 inch? That's where I'm confused.
Right.
I'm a rule person. I go by.
Right. Yeah.
But what would I be asking for relief from that I comply with the
you'd
zoning?
You'd just be asking for a larger. You'd be asking to overrule what the design review board approved.
I'm just not aware that the zoning hearing board has any jurisdiction over overruling something that isn't that's already compliant with the zoning ordinance. I'm not even sure they would have jurisdiction to do that.
Well, we're in charge of the law of the sign, so things have to comply according to the technical guidelines, but we also are responsible for the aesthetic of the signage. So that's where there's some gray. I understand what you're saying. I totally get it, but there's some gray there because we can't, we don't approve every single sign that comes through here just because it fits within the guidelines. There has to be some kind, that's why we exist. It's to create an overall aesthetic that we feel as a board is appropriate for the surrounding businesses in the town.
And I understand that. I appreciate that. But my understanding was your role was advisory.
No.
So I'm just not sure. I have to say I've been doing this for 17 years, and I've never had to appeal a design review committee to the zoning hearing board.
A lot of communities don't have a design review board. And you're right. We are an advisory board. So we can make a motion to pass what we feel would look best in the community. And we all live in the community. So we answer to our neighbors who say, how could you let that huge sign? And it could be this thing, that thing, you know. I'm not saying necessarily Five Below, but there's always a conversation what does the village look like? What does the community look like now?
But that's what the zoning ordinance is there for. That's what, there could be specific guidelines for a village district for certain uses within the district for certain guidelines.
It would be
that
nice
would
if it was
that.
More specific, but this is just the way this works.
Yeah. I mean, you feel that's going to create a hardship if you got 22-inch letters versus 27?
I think if you guys are coming into 25.
Yeah. I mean, you're coming into Radnor. You want to be a team player. Yeah. We're just asking you to join the team and try to be neighborly
and
it's not
looking for 36. Or
right. Right.
We're
right.
We're not seeking relief for it.
Exactly.
We're looking for something that 27 inches and some of the things that we take into account. You hear this all the time.
I'm sorry.
I don't mean to be repetitive from what you normally hear, but we take into account the distance from the road and the speed that people travel and the ability to recognize our sign.
Right.
And, if I may look, just refer to the site plan here, it's an aerial that's in your package, but I could do it here, is we're actually on the far left of the strip. And as you'll see in that strip, there is a substantial amount of vegetation, trees, which do limit the visibility. So as you're coming across, you have small little windows of opportunity to see us.
Yeah.
And so the bigger the sign, the better it is for people to recognize that we are. Chances are they may be already past that first entrance and will have to hit the second entrance, but we want to make sure that they have the ability to see where we are.
I really understand what you're saying.
Yeah. I
mean, I completely understand your standpoint and that you represent, Five Below, and you need to get the best representation for them in the community so they're well seen.
But I also like to add, there's also a number of other national tenants that are in Radnor Township that have gone up in front of that podium, just as you are doing right now. And there's a process. Mm-hmm. And from Rite Aid, Wawa, probably Chipotle and every other shop in the shopping center, as well as up and down Lancaster Avenue, they went through the same process.
Okay.
So there's an aesthetic that we're trying to achieve. For the greater good of Radnor Township.
Was there a number that we can come in between 22 and 27, like 25?
No. I'm 22 is my max also.
Yeah, I think it's...
I mean, again, given the distance to the roadway as well as the fact that
this is 12 inches here. You could see this if you were standing on the other side of the building. Yeah. And we drive here all day, every day. I'm up and down that street. I promise you, you stand out. I know you'd like to have something bigger because you'd stand out even more, but people will find you. Five Below is a well-known brand. You come to Wayne, you know you're going to be found.
You are going to stand out with your sign itself with
these are very bold letters.
With the color of the blue, you are going to stand out. You're going to stand out at night.
I mean,
without a light.
Yeah, Five Guys is 18, and you can see that without any problem. You guys are going to jump a lot more with that blue background and larger letters and Five Guys and all. Yeah, I would say 22 would be more than enough. More than enough.
We're going to hear about it even at 22.
I know
at 22. I know you're caving at 22.
I am caving.
I'm caving.
Yeah, I'm caving. Just, I'm going to jump off of that for a second. The awnings, you guys are going to reskin the awnings with the corporate colors?
Yes.
Okay, you're going to use umbrella?
Yes, that's correct.
Okay, good. Okay. No lettering on your awnings, it's just...
That's fine.
Okay, all right. Okay. All right, getting back to the letter size. I know, we're in a tough position, too. We're in a real tough position.
I don't know who we've given 22 inches to. And I know yours is, you know, it's a condensed logo, too, so I get that you know, that big space.
I do think sometimes variation looks good in certain locations. I mean, you see some strip centers where the signs are exactly the same, you know, 18-inch channel letters, and it's just, it's kind of blah. So I think you want some...
I mean, we gave CVS 16-inch letters. They're almost across the street from you. That's a pretty big national brand.
It is.
They might have more stores than even you guys.
And they are right up against the road. They have an advantage to us.
They have parking in front of them. They're not right up against the road. They probably have 8 parking spaces in front of them and a sidewalk, so you probably have 20.
Also, I just want to point out, in fairness to some of your other neighboring stores here, they went through the same process. So, you know, for you to demand and to get, you know, a 27, 26, 24-inch lettering, when we held Five Guys to what, 18 inches?
But again, as we mentioned, we're double the size of some of those other stores.
Your storefront. And where the signage is going is not double the size of Five Guys. If you look at it, it looks like it's...
It looks pretty much the same width as Five Guys.
It's already going to dominate, plus it's, the letters are bigger and they're bolder and bright, on a bright blue background. So it's already, like when I look at this picture, it's already going to stand out. Even if it was 20, it would stand out. But 22
is
it's
going to
be noticeably bigger because of the scale of the letters in addition to the height.
All right, we need to move it along. So, yes. Okay. We're kind of standstill here.
Still 22 or 20?
Yeah.
All
right. I where are you? To be at 20, but 22 is. I'm trying to understand where they're coming from, but that's my max.
Okay. Where are you, Dave?
It's fine.
Any comments, Ray? Okay. I mean, I'd love to see somehow where you guys can mock that up on the building. And I guarantee you, you're going to get plenty of bang for the buck at 22 inches with that blue board in the back.
Yeah.
You know, and again, that board can't extend higher than 15 feet, so make sure of that. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't know how much, you know, space there is between the board and the top of those letters, but 15 foot max. So,
yeah, I think even at 18 inches, I'm not going to restrict.
Yeah,
but I just say even at 18 inches with the sight line going up and down Lancaster Avenue from both entrances to that shopping center, you're going to catch that.
Yeah.
You're going to catch your sign.
That's why I'm thinking if you look at Five Guys, you know, it's a similar in terms of width across the space, and they have 18 inches. If you were at 20, you'd still have, you know, a larger letter than the others in the strip, and you'd have, you know, the bright blue backing that would make it pop even more.
Mm-hmm. And that's what's first going to catch your eye is basically
all the blue.
The blue, that's your trademark.
I'll be honest with you, I think there's going to be such a buzz when you guys come into town, you guys could do business without even putting a sign up.
Yep.
I think, you know, I think that's the power of Five Guys. Mm-hmm. Or excuse me, five below.
Five
I
below.
Say.
But there's so much traffic in that strip now. I mean, you have, you know,
you guys should have a home run location there.
I hope so.
I think you will, you know. Yeah.
Without a doubt.
So it's a busy location with a lot of vehicles up and down Route 30 and, you know.
Okay.
So, all right. What do you think? Join the team?
Well, we're gonna discuss our options.
Okay.
Okay.
Moving forward. So I guess your motion
Ray,
then
can we do
is
this? Can we run through some of the other applicants and have them come up at the end of the meeting? Is that all right?
You want to discuss?
Oh no, we're going to probably discuss it. He has to go back to headquarters and talk about it.
Okay, so we'll make a motion and you'll take that back.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And we'll
So our motion will also be the recommendation to zoning. So when you go to zoning, you know, you should know that obviously there can be public discussion there that people may come or may not. You may just get the 27 inches by, you know, zoning. They'll say, oh yeah, you should have it. So if you want to appeal it, I understand that.
Okay.
So do we want to do a continuation on this? Good chance you guys will be back next month to see us, correct?
So does that work?
No, about that. No, just do whatever you're going to, whatever motion you're going to make is fine, and then we'll just decide.
Let's just make a motion.
Okay, go ahead.
All right, in the manner of DRB, I put my days, DRB 2016-27, Five Below for 309 East Lancaster Avenue in Wayne, I move that the sign be accepted as presented with the stipulation that the letter size be reduced to 22 inches and that it not exceed 15 feet when you hang your sign.
Okay, let's just make sure that the pylons match the other colors.
Oh, the pylons should match the other colors. Thank you.
Okay. And you probably heard a conversation before about the address. Just make sure the address is on the building, too, if you would, please.
Yes.
Okay. At least 4-inch letters. Okay. All right. Do we hear a second on that?
I second.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, great. All right. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Thanks for
appreciate
coming.
It. All right, next is DRB 2016-28, the application of Vodafol at 321 West Lancaster Avenue in Wayne for a ground sign and a wall sign. Hi, Brian.
How are you?
And I believe we have some new plans, Brian, in front of us.
I do. I just have a little more detail.
Okay.
Where is this one?
This is right across from Chili's.
Okay.
Remember Broughton from Radnor High School?
Who?
Broughton. He was in my class. That was his family house when we went to school.
Okay.
Yeah. Right next to, if you're looking at Sherwin Williams to the left, okay. Right across from Chili's.
Okay.
Brian, want to use the handheld? Easier for
you. You know, I love these letters.
Dr. Sorge was unable to visit with us tonight. She got called to Manhattan on a procedure, but she wanted me to represent her business. And if I could at the end, just give like a 30-second or a 45-second blurb.
Mm-hmm.
Can you hear me okay?
Mm-hmm.
We're looking at two signs. One's a wall sign, and one is a post and panel sign. The wall sign is decorative. It's a leaf that's internally illuminated. The sides of it are made out of brushed stainless steel, and then the face is Lexan, and it's digitally printed and internally illuminated with LEDs.
So that's just to the side of the door there.
Yeah, well, that's the leaf in their logo.
Mm-hmm.
If you look at the post and panel sign in your copy, you'll see that the leaf is part of the V
mm-hmm.
in Vitaful.
Mm-hmm.
And so we just wanted to take one of those elements and just place it on the stone, just to draw you into the building. The doctor purchased this building and mm-hmm. is utilizing all three floors for treatment.
Mm. Is this, what will the leaf be made out of?
The leaf will be made out of that material right there,
mm-hmm.
as far as the edges.
Yeah.
And then the face will be Lexan.
Okay.
And it will be digitally printed.
Mm. Very attractive. This sign's very attractive.
I know you guys like elements, decorative elements, so.
Would that be viewed as signage, or would that be viewed as?
That's signage.
Or is it like an art element?
No, I think that's signage.
It's signage.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Back to the discussion we had, what was it, with Harvest Restaurant?
Yeah. They wanted it.
Above.
Too high.
Above.
That was a problem.
So if they dropped 15. It down, they could have done it.
Right.
There was nowhere to drop it, but.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, it looks great. It's got all the right information on it. It's the right size. It's a.
Mm-hmm.
And then the other sign on the, that's a, if you look, there's a cement, loss of words here tonight.
Podium.
There's a cement mound there. I looked at the condition of that. It is exactly 10 foot 8 inches from where it should be, but I just put 10 foot, I just rounded it up.
Okay.
So it is perfect
it's
where
perfect.
It should
yeah,
be.
Good.
The only problem is right now there's wooden. If you look at that first page that I gave mm-hmm. you in your packet, you'll see a picture of the banner. that's currently there. And you'll see that there's wooden posts that are coming up through the cement. Mm-hmm. And I did not like the way that looked. So I'm recommending to my client that we remove those wood posts altogether just because they're very rickety.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And we could either use that pad site to attach the solid aluminum poles to it. Mm-hmm. And we would actually drill into that cement pad. Mm-hmm. And drop some bolts down in there. That's really what I would recommend.
Okay, so this is out, this is in.
Correct.
Okay.
Yeah.
But they haven't
the sign is actually made out of aluminum. Not stainless steel. So the poles, the poles and the panel are all aluminum. The background is actually a print. But the vitafoil, including the leaf, is actually made out of that stainless steel material that I gave you. Mm-hmm. It's all fabricated. The only difference with that being is that's 2.5 inches of a return. And this would only be 2 inches of a return on each side. And so it would stand out.
Still stand out a lot.
And it would be polished. And there is ground lighting there already. Mm-hmm. She's going to be upgrading the ground lighting, just changing out the heads with something a little nicer. Mm-hmm. So that it would be distributing the light more evenly on the sign.
Okay.
The material of that is a baked enamel finish. It's a two-part poly, mm-hmm. baked enamel. It's really nice. It's a Dornotic bronze color.
Brian, the base itself, I know, needs some repair.
And that would be repaired, yeah.
But what do you think they would do there?
Well, the actual structure itself is in great condition.
Right.
What I would love to do is after we attach the post to it in a professional manner,
right.
is I would like to either cover it with stucco or cover it with brick. I think brick would look really pretty.
Mm-hmm. Brick would look pretty. I mean, it's not consistent with the building, no. but it would look good with that sign.
Mm-hmm.
I think we'd be okay with either one.
I'm okay with either one.
Yeah, I mean, stucco would be obviously a very cost-effective way of doing it.
Right.
This looks nice. This will be great.
But she has not signed off on a sign yet?
Oh, we had a conversation. She's, like I said, she's in Manhattan, and I had the entire conversation I'm having with you. She loves what we've done.
Okay. All right.
And then she wanted me to give her a blurb, too.
Okay.
Good.
All right. Why don't we, so we're good with the wall sign, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We're all in agreement with that.
Yep.
And the monument sign, we're okay with that?
Yes.
So location's all right. Material's good. Lighting, you said she's just going to change the...
Correct.
Well, you're going to do that?
Yeah, we're going to put new heads
on. The electric won't change. It's just going to be the coverings.
Correct.
Cover.
Okay. I know the street number isn't on the sign. I know it's not great looking, but I'm always driving around looking for places thinking, what number is this? What number is this? It would be nice if the number was somewhere visible.
Well, we could put the number to the left of the doors on the stone or on the glass.
Well, that would be, at least you'd be able to see them.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Maybe just right underneath the monument sign. Just have
maybe on the base.
Can you put it on the base, maybe, of the monument?
Have it like right here.
Yeah.
I don't know if the base would be high enough to...
Bottom of the sign itself. Just have
in the sign area?
Yeah, I was just saying, it's like just right under it. It's like a box right under it. Just have some sort of identification. I would think as a business owner, you would want to...
I always think a business owner would want their street number on there, too, because when you look them up, you're looking to see, okay, let's see, I'm at 175, 270, where am I in the right block? But I wouldn't be opposed to having them right on the building there.
No,
at least
I
you
would.
Can find
either
them.
Either way,
You could do...
Or on the door.
Or on both,
the door, but it's hard to see them on the door when you're driving by. What if you... I tell you about your business, Brian. I'm just kidding.
No.
You could do like little pin letters.
I just don't want it to distract from her sign. I mean, I think on the building would be really cool.
I think it would be good on the building.
Yeah. I would just think if you're going up and down Lancaster Avenue, your eye is going to catch the monument sign versus the building if you're trying to figure out where's the address.
Mm-hmm.
321 West Lancaster Avenue. My eye's not going to, if I'm going up on driving, going west, and I'm on the right side of the road, my eye's not going to catch that building looking for the address. You'll see the monument sign.
Now, I hear your point, but as a sign maker, I would rather advertise your business than advertising the location.
So maybe you could put, you think on the stone?
I think on the stone, if you make it fairly large.
Yeah. It'll stand out.
And tasteful.
Yeah.
Sure. It would stand out. Okay. And if you look at our building, we have our our number.
I can find you.
And you can, it's and it's on the building. It's not on my pylon sign.
No.
Okay. I think we valued Brian's judgment.
I think I would leave that up to your discretion.
Long and often. Yeah.
Just, but,
Okay.
You and the client.
All right. Good. All right. Any other things about the sign? Questions? Brian, questions for us? Comments? Anything like that?
No.
Okay. Why don't we
approve
it, and then Brian's going to give us
a
30-second commercial.
Got it.
Okay. So who wants to take that one? Who's, I get David's turn.
In the matter of DRB 2016-2028 for the submittal of the application for approval of the wall sign and monument sign by Vitiful, I submit that we approve the their application.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. And Brian, does Peggy have a correct a copy?
Yes, correct.
Okay, you have it for files. Okay, good. All right.
Vitiful, Dr. Surge is an MD, just to let you know, but Vitiful is an anti-aging and alternative medicine clinic. They host a variety of complementary medical solutions to common acute and chronic health problems, speeding recovery from illness, injuries, and unfavorable lifestyle choices that contribute to the negative effects of age. They have a hyperbaric oxygen chamber, ozone therapy protocols. The ozone therapy protocols focus on oxygenating while our individual vitamin, mineral, and amino acid IVs bring intravenous nutrition to wounded or deteriorated organs. They help with people who are suffering from cancer and cancer treatment as well. The individual displays various distinguishing marks of chronological aging, and they offer skin rejuvenation treatments such as microneedling, Pure P facelift, dermal fillers, Miracule thread lift, Exilis protege radio frequency, skin resurfacing, Meteostar Next Pro hair removal, Vanquish MERF body fat removal, and many other cutting-edge aesthetic treatments. Vitiful wants to help you feel and good and look good inside and out.
All right.
Thank you.
We wish them luck.
Yeah, we wish them luck. When does she think she'll be open to open her practice? Is it already open?
No.
Oh.
No. In another month.
Oh, good for her.
They have all the
good.
They have all the equipment in there. She has about $4 or $5 million of equipment.
Wow.
Really? It sounded like it.
Built.
Yeah.
Well, you gotta get at least $1 million for this sign in, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's nice to see you, Brian.
All right, Brian. Take care.
Bye-bye.
Don't forget your... Hi, Brian. Next is DRB 2016-29, the application at Glenbrook Avenue Investors, LLC, at 816 to 818 Glenbrook Avenue in Bryn Mawr for awning, facade renovations, and an addition. Hello there.
Good evening.
Hi.
I'm Peter Bloomfield. I'm the architect representing RIR Management, the developers of the property.
Nice to have you here.
To acquaint you, that's upside down.
Yeah, thank you.
This is a great tool.
Isn't it really awesome?
This is really terrific. The property that we're talking about.
Mr. Bloomfield? Mr. Bloomfield.
I'm sorry.
Let me give you the handheld. I think it'll be a little easier for you. There you go.
Thank you.
Okay.
My band could use one of these. the property that we're talking about, there are two buildings, and I'll go through them separately, is all the way over here at the edge of the township.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, Bryn Mawr Hospital controls most of this area around it. And as you see from the photographs, it's a the zoning is C1. The neighborhood is a combination of light commercial and residential, for lack of a better description. The building, this piece right here is the thrift shop from the hospital. A bunch of pieces that continue on down the street are empty. And our goal is to basically take the existing building. We have zoning approval for to put in this parking back here, and this is the first building that we're talking about.
So what was in there previously?
Pardon me?
What was in there previously?
Apartments and kind of commercial downstairs.
Elements of the thrift.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's right. It was a thrift. Yeah.
Looks so good, what you've done. Well, I mean.
Oh, you know something?
It's upside down, but it still looks good.
Even upside down, it looks good.
8, 6, 8.
Yeah.
We made some minor changes to the original packages that we gave you, and here are upgrades as well as color samples.
Okay, here. I can hand them out.
Yeah. And then if you give me one, I'll take it over to code enforcement. Thank you.
Nice color.
Great.
It's just, will that be the beginning of the rehabbing of that street?
Your lips to God's ear.
Yeah.
Actually, we started the restaurant.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That's the beginning. You're right.
Going? Very well.
I like the colors.
So what we're doing essentially is taking off that piece and replacing it with a very simple canopy. Mm-hmm. The letters are within code at 8 inches. The canopy is somewhere between 9.5 and 10 inches deep. It'll have a wood ceiling and one recessed can just lighting each entry door.
Mm-hmm. Can I just ask a quick question?
Yeah.
The current building right now, is that for the drop-off for the thrift shop? That's a building before that on the right?
I'm sorry. Can I just step up to the mic and just let us know who you are, too, please?
Sure. Tim Rubin. Mm-hmm. The thrift drop-off is actually still owned by the hospital, by Mainline Health, and it's the middle portion of that Five Points intersection.
Okay.
So this is the part that angles off on Glenbrook.
Okay.
So it's across Glenbrook.
Got it.
From this.
Okay. Thank you.
Tim, it may have been the drop-off years ago, wasn't it?
Yeah, this was the building in the rear on the, just to orient you on this plan, the building that gets raised that is currently located back here was the original drop-off. And then they had elements of the drop-off.
Is right
on
there.
One of the lower levels.
Right. Yep.
I think it's this building.
So you're right, that's right across the street from the Wawa. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we see the canopy is painted, the sample that you have there. One color is for the stucco, which is going to get restored and replaced or repaired, and painted that color. And the rest of it is basically wood infill systems. Yeah. Thank you. And actually, I can probably skip all of the other boards. And we can go right to the next building, if that's okay.
Well,
they are separate items.
Okay, let's just finish up with this. So you're going to build a utility room, right? You're going to have a build-out on this building?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay. All right, so basically you're going to put an addition on the building.
Yeah, it's a minor, I think it's 3 feet by 7 feet,
okay.
8 feet, and it'll house the water meters.
Okay.
Yep.
All right. How about, the materials, I think we're pretty clear cut on stucco color, painted metal color, and all that, so we're good there. You guys?
All right. Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
yeah,
I do too,
it's
yeah.
Great.
And the lighting, you just said there's one light going in?
One light over each door.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and I think, do we have the cut it at or not?
Yes, the cut is in there. It's a recessed can. Okay, I believe it's the last light fixture.
Okay, sidewalks, no changes to the sidewalks?
To the sidewalks?
Yes.
No.
Existing sidewalks today.
Well, they're going to have to be repaired, but other than that.
Okay.
Yes.
And really, the only signage would be the identification numbers of the building.
That's correct.
Okay. How about trash?
Trash is basically, there's an agreement between the restaurant property and this property, and it'll be right about there.
Okay. We always ask you to fence it in if you can. Okay. Okay, shield it as best you can. Okay. I guess really no landscaping to speak of, right?
Minor, right in here and that area. But it's not on the street, so it's hardly. I mean, we're really right next to the parking lot for the SEPTA station.
Right. Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. And I guess parking signs, handicap signs, anything like that that we should be aware of?
Striped according to code.
Okay. All right.
Are you going to be using the original windows, or are you going to be replacing?
They're all new.
All new.
Okay. There are, and a couple of the side windows are getting filled in, and a couple are being expanded.
So there's no historical issues or anything like that?
No.
In this building. Right. What's going to be the purpose at the end of the day when you have the thing renovated? The office or residential?
Apartments.
Apartments?
Downstairs also?
Yep.
Yep.
The downstairs one's going to be pretty cool. It's a big loft, basically.
It looks cool. Yeah.
That's a hot area down there.
Yeah.
Well, we're hoping the residents and the nursing staff think this is a nice place to live.
Sure.
I think it looks like a nice place to live.
Thank you.
Right. Okay.
Anything else we should be aware of on the plan?
Nothing I can think of, you gents.
Questions for the group here? Comments, questions?
It's a great area.
Ray, any questions do you have or comments, Ray?
No, not for us. Again, fire department connections, horn stroves, knox boxes, those type of things.
Okay.
We'll handle that. We discussed, I think, a railing or two to make sure people don't fall down the little stairwells and things. But
okay.
Yeah, we're matching the existing rails, and that's about it.
It's a good application. Thank you. So why don't we make an approval for this building?
Yeah.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know who wants to take it. I guess. Lisa, maybe your turn.
Yeah. It's a matter of DRB 2016-29. I move that we approve the building renovation, awning, facade renovation, and addition is submitted.
Okay, here a second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, so last on our agenda tonight is DRB 2016-30, the application of Glenbrook Avenue Investors LLC, 820 Glenbrook Avenue, Bryn Mawr, awning and addition.
It's the same story.
Yep.
It's the building right next door. Actually, I think it's a little more elegant in that we've got just a smaller canopy over the one main entrance.
Mm-hmm. Did I get it backwards again?
It's a challenge.
The only two buildings that are like this, or it continues on, doesn't it? Aren't there a number of buildings?
There are. There's a third one that is, we're going to sort of see how this goes before my clients jump into that one. And there are a number of other sort of buildings in the area that are apartments of this scale. I don't think any of them have been upgraded.
At least I think, I think your mic's off, actually.
You think what? Lisa's your mic's off.
Sorry. That's okay.
They're all like, she said important things here.
Yeah, really.
You know, for our viewers at home.
Might have to go back and redo it all. Yeah. No, I think it looks tremendous. I mean,
what's the width of the apartments?
Where's my staff when I need
it? No, that's okay. It's just kind of a personal interest.
You know, I tell you what, I'll gladly email you the plans. They're a very gracious. One and two bedroom apartments, large, and they have windows on the sides. So all the apartments will have windows actually on three sides.
Hmm. Is your email on here?
No, but my card is right here.
So they like 1,500 to 1,800 square feet, something like that?
Oh, no. They're about 1,100.
Yeah.
500.
I'm 1100. Just thinking about the apartment I already own. That's what I'm thinking.
What price point are you targeting?
You really shouldn't be asking. Huh.
Oh. Okay. All right.
Sorry, that's the realtor in me. No, it's just.
I think looks really good. I think.
Okay.
Okay.
It does. Any other questions, comments? Okay. Nope. Any comments, questions for us, guys? Okay. All right. Cindy, you want to finish up?
Yeah, in the matter of DRB 2016-30, Glenbrook Avenue, 820 Glenbrook Avenue, I move that we accept the proposal as presented, or the design as presented.
Is there a second?
Second.
A second.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Appreciate
Thank
that.
Now, can we ask?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, let's finish. Any other business for our board tonight? Old business.
All that public comment.
New business. No. Public participation.
No, it would be appropriate to say I think we should refine the code, the DRB code. You know, people come and they often don't know why we are arbitrary about letter sign, and I think we should have that in there.
Yeah. Well, it's funny. David and I were kind of talking before the meeting, and I was telling him that like years ago they were talking about maybe redoing the book. And,
yeah, just a couple
of
years ago.
We made notations in the book. Things that we saw, there were gray areas and all that. But I think it's probably a lot of work. And, of course, it's more of an internal thing than our board. So we can always bring that up to Kevin or Ray or Bill and see if they have enough time and effort to do it. You know,
okay.
I think there would be.